This is Chrisferb, and I'm going to review how to make a control chart. So this first video is mainly how to actually create it in Excel. It should work in Office 365 as well, the Excel version. It doesn't use the any type of special toolkits. So we have our data here, and what we're going to do is we're going to find the average of this data. So I'm going to click in this little field down here that's right underneath the word average. And then I'm going to go up to the formula bar and hit enter. And then I'm going to type AV. And you see that our average function is in one of the options. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the first value and go all the way down to the last one so that we get the range of our values that we're looking for. And then do close parentheses. That's our average. So now what I'm going to do is in this control line area, I'm going to reference the average value right there. And I want to just reference it because if the average changes, we want this control line to change. So it's going to be equals. And it's going to be equals. And then it's going to be the value of this one right here, which is D36. So now I'm going to do a dollar sign and a D, and then a dollar sign and 36. This is called an absolute reference. So it's referencing absolutely the D column and absolutely the 36 row. And that is so that when I go and I move this down with a little autofill, it doesn't do a relative reference, which means it would move it down just as I move it down. So we have the same value. We have the correct value in here. So now for lower, all that we need to do is it's three standard deviations below the mean, and the upper is three standard deviations above the mean, and it can be done differently, different control charts. Usually it's three. And then so what we're going to do first, we're going to find the standard deviation. So when we find the standard deviation, we're going to go like this. There's different standard deviations that you can put in here, different types of formulas, but I'm going to do this. I'm going to show you. S, T. So now we have different things that are popping up here. So we're going to use standard deviation, but it's the sample formula, and that's the S. It's usually the one that people use because the population is saying that you're using population data, and it's not quite as practical usually, but we're going to say this is sample data. So we have standard dev dot S. And so now all that we do is we're going to go and pick our values again and hit, and then they're selected. And then just like we did before, I'm going to do close parentheses. Okay, now we have the standard deviation. And then now we can go and we can do the lower and the upper. And so all that we need to do, because now we have the average and the standard deviation. So for the lower, it's going to be the mean, and then we're going to subtract 3 times the standard deviation. And so that's going to be equals. So I'm going to go and use D4, and that's because that whole column is the average or the mean. And then I'm going to do subtract, and I'm going to do parentheses. Let's see, 3 times, and then it's going to be the standard deviation, which is E36, and I'm going to use absolute reference for this. So it's going to be E, and then absolute, 36, and then I'm not sure if I need closing parentheses all the way around it, but I'm going to put them in. Okay, so that's our lower limit. I don't usually like to have negatives as the lower limit, but that's the way it works out with our data and with our standard deviation. I'd like to have a tighter one, but it works perfectly fine. Okay, so now all I'm going to do is drag this right down. And then that works, okay. And then for the upper, I'm actually just going to copy this formula and then just adapt it slightly because it's very similar. So I'm going to pull it right over And it's not right the way it is now, but I'm going to click on this one. And all that we need to do, we have the absolute reference of our mean, which is fine. But we want to go over and we want to make it plus. And so now let's take a look. E4. No, we want it to be D4. Okay, we want it to be D4. Okay, so it's D4, which is our mean, plus the 3 times our standard deviation. Let's give it a shot. Okay, there's our upper limit. So now, all that I'm going to do is pull this right down. And now what we have is we have all of the data for our control chart. So now all that I'm going to do is select it. We don't need to select the standard deviation and the average. So we just select this whole whole table. And then I'm going to do insert, recommended charts, and it's going to pull up what we're looking for. And I'm going to go right down to this one right here, which is what our control chart looks like, or will look like. And I'm going to make it larger. And so what you could do is go in here and modify. You can add things and modify the way it looks. You can change the title, make it say control chart. But this is the basic control chart. Like I said, the standard deviation is pretty wide on this one. So it actually goes and it has a broad range. It would be slightly better if it was a tighter standard deviation, and then this control line would not be below zero. But that's okay. This is how it works. And then in the next video, we'll talk about what it means when we have, say, 3 points that are above the control line, or data that's like that. So thank you for watching, and I hope this made sense. And keep an eye out for the next video. Thanks.